Hey there guys, Paul here. In this video, I'm going to be walking you through some tips and tricks to help you use the Coolselector 2 application like a pro. Coming up, page segmentation, navigation and inputs, checking calculations of selected components, and generating reports. This video is part of a series where we'll be looking at a number of worked examples using the Coolselector 2 application to help you select and calculate components for your refrigeration system. So do check out the other videos if you haven't already. Links are in the video description below. As you will notice, the Coolselector application has been designed with an intuitive layout which leads you through the selection process to help you select different system components. Each component selection screen will follow a similar layout using several segments to assist you in defining the system and narrowing your search down to find the most relevant product. Each segment can be minimized or expanded using the resize button located in the top right corner of the segment. We always start the selection process from the application segment located in the top left-hand panel. This segment lets you define the system type or application, the component's location within the system, the refrigerant being used, the connection type, as well as the product family. Other selections, such as compressors and condensing units, will ask you for additional details such as the intended region for the application, the type of power supply available, as well as advanced product filters. Next, we move on to the operating condition segment, which lets you define the capacity as well as the evaporator and condenser temperatures. This section will have a significant impact on your product recommendation and selection. The default values are based on assumptions which might not be applicable to your system, so it's very important that you take care with this segment to ensure correct values are used. Within the subsections, you might find drop-down menus which allow you to define the operating conditions based on different information you hold about the system. Cells which are colored white are required, whereas cells which are blue are optional. The data entered into the blue cells will not change the product selection, but it may affect the results. For example, changing the condensation temperature will alter the heating capacity. Next, we have the product selection segment. Your input here, along with the operating conditions, shape how a product will be suggested to you in the next segment. The next segment is the selection table. This segment lists the most applicable products as well as a suggested product based on the selection criteria and the operating conditions defined previously. The suggested product is automatically selected. You can select another product by clicking on the row. You will notice that the row for the suggested product will then be highlighted in green, so you can go back to this if you wish. Some products, such as compressors, will have other options per model. These can be viewed or hidden using the expand and minimize buttons. You may find that products are highlighted with red text. This is to warn you that the product doesn't match the operating conditions criteria based on your inputs. The match tolerance varies depending on the product you are selecting. For example, a compressor has a tolerance of plus or minus 10% match for your defined capacity as default. However, this can be altered within preferences. Other products may have multiple match criteria, such as a maximum speed, a minimum opening degree, or minimum pressure drop. Coolselector 2 warns you if any of the required criteria is not met. A warning message displays above the table stating the issue. Alternatively, a product can have multiple warnings, and you can view them by placing your mouse over the warning symbol within the end column of the table. The table will show relevant information for the products. This can be changed by right-clicking on the table column titles and selecting Manage Columns. Additionally, the table can be exported by right-clicking on the table data and selecting Export to Excel. The final segment we're going to look at is the performance segment. This segment shows the relevant performance details for the product you select. This information updates if you choose another product from the list. The tabs in this segment will let you view performance data and product information in chart and table formats. The information available will vary depending on what type of product you're selecting. Some products, such as compressors, will provide important information such as cooling capacity, current, and mass flow rates. This data is shown in a graph format by default, but there is also a radio button to view the data in a table format. This table can then be exported by right-clicking on the cell values and selecting Export to Excel. Once you have filled in the necessary details to reach the product suggestion and selection stage, you're able to view the calculations and the thermodynamic data for a product in the performance segment. You can view the details for any product on the list simply by selecting it from the table above. The data will then automatically refresh. Within the performance segment, you will find a number of tabs which vary depending on the product. All products that require a system calculation will display a tab labeled Performance Details. Within Performance Details, you will find system schematics and thermodynamic data. These can be used to check the product's compatibility with your system and design. Data displayed in chart format can be exported simply by right-clicking on the table and clicking Export to Excel. Additionally, you can save your project for future reference by clicking File, then Save As in the top menu bar. You will be prompted to select a save location and a file name. You can generate a report for your selected product by clicking on the Report button in the top menu bar. A report will then generate showing the default information for your selected components. At the beginning of the report is the Project Information section. If you haven't set this up to show your name by default, then this section will be blank. You can enter the details on the left-hand panel and then click the Update button to apply these. Additionally, you can save time in future by entering your name to show as default. To do this, click on the Options in the top main menu bar and then click on Users, Language and Country. Then, just enter the name you would like to show as default and click OK. We covered this step previously in much more detail within the introductory video. If you missed that, you can find links to this in the video description below. As mentioned, the report will display some product information as default. You have the option to include much further detail or remove information by clicking on the plus icons in the left-hand panel under Items to Include in the Report. You can then select or unselect the different options. Once you're satisfied, simply click the Update button to apply these to the report. The report can then be printed, saved as a PDF, or exported to various mediums using the buttons just above the report. Okay, that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. We hope you enjoyed this and it has helped you. If so, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. If you have any questions, let us know in the comment section down below. You can also find links to more Coolselector tutorials in the video description. Don't forget to check those out. And once again, thanks for watching.